dipping his fingers into the other games.
He's been in the no practice zone for Smash 4, but we have him in both grand finals for Street Fighter 5 and Tekken 7.
Dude, that's sick. That is really sick. If only he made it to grand finals for Melee, but you know, you got a long ways to go, kid.
Yeah, and I heard he's now using Peach for Melee.
He's a Peach. Yo, he's a Peach player. Because when he was trying to decide main, we were like, oh, we have lack of Peaches. So he's like, okay, let's do it. Let's play Peach. Oh, are we starting now?
Oh, we are starting grand finals.
Wait, are we really starting it? Oh my gosh.
All right, welcome to grand finals for Smash 4. Let's give it up for Marcelo Rodriguez and Matthew Fernandez. Matthew Fernandez uses Link, and Marcelo Rodriguez is using Rob.
Matthew and Rob, Marcelo is a veteran of this scene. He's been winning, you know, he's been like maybe top three in all the tournaments he's been going. He actually went to EVO. Matthew is kind of a new up-and-comer.
He is definitely a new face. He did so well in this tournament, and he is actually on winner's side of Grand Finals.
Winner's side?
Yes.
Wait, did he beat Marcelo getting into this?
He beat Brian, and he beat me as well.
No, because the last time I saw Matthew, he was like, forgive me for the choice of words, with Cool Fodder. He was like pretty much like in the lower bracket and was getting O2'd, but it's so nice to see that this kid has made it all the way up to winner's side of Grand Finals. Anyway, let's get into the game. Like, Marcelo in the clear for Sent Lead, but you never know with Smash 4 Link with the Rage Effect right now. He's in the Rage Effect for Sent.
Yeah, if he can somehow find a way to actually get him with a forward smash, he might be able to kill the Rob. But Marcelo over here using good use of the gyro, you know, to keep him off stage.
He's doing a really great job with the projectiles, but at the same time, Link, a huge arsenal of projectiles as well. Oh!
Super dangerous if used in the correct way as well. Alright, so there's the gyro.
Right at the edge, but honestly, like, watching Smash 4...
Ooh! That did not spike, he got lucky.
I feel like this game, you need to land a solid, clean hit, a clean finisher versus like any edgeguard situation.
Yeah.
Oh. Ooh, there you go, right. Dude.
So like, down throw to take out the
pile
first stock.
Driver right there, take the stock. Let's go, Marcelo.
WWE. Oh, that was really bad. Okay, he's doing the gyro combo right now. Alright, so he got out of it. There goes the beam. Ooh, hit him with both hits of the fair.
Ooh. Nice leap to the left.
This is just a straight up projectile battle going on right now.
I don't even think they're like, they don't care about Samir. They're just going in, they're trading hits. They're just,
fair.
That punish on the dare.
Oh, he got him with dare into the grab. Oh!
Nice.
There goes
the
stock. Alright, I believe Matthew can still do this. Link hits pretty hard with that Master Sword. Uh-oh.
It's not the hero time for it. Hero time versus the robot. Let's go.
Yeah.
Nice. Down air to an up air. So forward smash.
Alright.
Marcelo charging that thingy.
The gyro.
Charging his fidget spinner. Let's go.
Oh, side there you go. Alright.
Oh my god.
Oh!
Nice wall tech into up air. Up air, up B, I'm sorry. Did he grab that bomb and work back down at him?
Yeah. Alright, okay, he's still gonna be able to make it. Oh boy.
Bomb to cover the ledge. Let's see if he... Nice up lead out of shield. Right now they're throwing all this stuff. Final destination right now is giving you some seizures.
Yeah, you're looking at Earth and the sun.
Really great.
Oh, right, nice pivot grab. Is he alive? Nice DI.
Oh, he almost got him.
He missed the dare.
No, not like this.
All right, game one goes to Marcelo.
Okay, game one, Marcelo. The thing is, Marcelo's on the loser's side, so he needs to win five more games.
Yeah.
I mean, if he's going to go straight for a straight 6-0, he needs five more.
So three matches in total to actually reset the bracket, and then three more to win the tournament.
Oh.
It's always difficult from losers bracket. The loser side.
Oh yeah, it's very, very difficult. But you know what? Matthew earned it. He earned this easy win.
Alright,
by not losing.
So game two goes to Town and City.
Town and City with these three platforms. This changes the game significantly. Nice laser. like laser into the fidget spinner. I'm just gonna call it that, dude. Throw it at him.
Alright, got him with the fan.
Nice projectiles with the Gale Boomerang. Right?
Oh, tried to get him with the nail, but he perfect shielded it.
Oh. That is a sick combo.
Up air.
Ledge hop hook shot into grab. I mean, convert. What is that? Wait, I closed my eyes for a second, and what happened there?
So he had the bomb on him, so when he upbeat, even if he didn't make it, the bomb would explode, so he could use the second upbeat.
Okay, I didn't see that he had the bomb on him. Was that planned?
It's like essential to Link's recovery.
Nice to Gale rank to bring bomb. Where's it for the attack? Nice. Oh, this is a really great projectile game. Nice.
That is the first stock.
Yeah. I'm slipping with that tournament winner. Tournament winner being the... Wait, is tournament winner a thing in Smash Bros? Where they just jump off the ledge? They jump high.
You mean like a muscle stock?
Not really. Like, you jump really high, you're not able to do anything.
I don't think so.
But he got punished for it, though. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Nice
there. Oh! Forward smash!
Nice. Marcelo with a clean second game. He's up 2-0 against Matthew. More game from resetting the bracket.
This robot is just basically no laughing matter.
Wait, did Matthew and Marcelo meet at all in bracket?
In this one?
Yeah, in this one.
Not at all.
Could this be? Let's see if Marcelo can stop him. Let's go.
Yeah, I think this might be the first time they've actually met in bracket. 3, 2, 1,
go! Back to FD. Or some iteration of it. Is this like a? Is this FD?
Yeah, this
okay,
is
FD. Back to FD.
This is just normal Final Destination.
Right, normally you're not able to strike or to go back to a stage that you previously wanted, or whatever. But Matt isn't like chose this, so Marcel's like, okay, shoot, I won here, but if you want to play here again, let's go.
Yeah, the thing is, with all the movement changes, they've changed so many legal stages, so like right after this one match, all of the stages are like,
oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because they treat Battlefield and Dreamland sort of like the same stage, so if you ban Battlefield or Dreamland, another one gets banned as well.
And then he
tried to get him.
Oh, there you go.
He tried to put him in a tech situation where if he got hit by the gyro, he would have the tech to survive. Other, if he didn't, he'd fall off.
That meteor looked like a hit of Marcelo. Going in, man. Matt with the combos. He's putting relentless pressure on Marcelo right now. Marcelo's no time to breathe right now. He's got him stuck in shield, he's got him pressured in the corner. What is he gonna do? Okay, he's out of it. No, he's still in shield.
Yeah, those disjoints on the Master Sword, they're just ridiculous. Yeah. On any sword character, disjoints are just like your lifesaver.
Nice. Wait, is that a down air?
The spinning?
Yeah.
That's a down smash.
The down smash? Okay, that's cool. I should have figured usually that's the case.
Alright. So he's DI'ing upwards to actually avoid the up air. Oh,
okay,
that's
nice.
A stock.
Let's go, Marcelo. Let's go.
Oh, nice fair.
Not that I want Matthew to lose, but I just want to see some more games, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, nice power.
Okay, fair.
Fair.
Oh, alright.
Oh no, Marcelo grabbed the bomb and blew up in his face. No.
Nice nair. Fair. Oh, he didn't get the gyro or the fidget spinner. Alright.
Oh, no.
Nice fair, but he thought.
Unsafe on shield. Shield grab.
There's just so many things on the ground right now. It's like super hard to keep up with what's going on. Oh, nice. Got hit by the arrow.
Big projectile game, man.
Oh, that is not the stock yet. Nice DI. Alright, there goes the laser.
Laser. Okay. You got the bomb. Got there after the bomb.
And
that would have been it.
What?
Oh, okay. That's
now
it.
That's the style. All right, Matthew wins his first game. He's still alive.
Let's go.
right, what stage are we going to see in game four right now?
The final!
Back to Town and City. Let's go.
I believe this was where Marcelo won.
Marcelo won Town and City. 3, 2, 1, go!
The very sketchy thing about Town and City is that, okay, it has like three platforms, but at certain points, they'll just move, and if you're still on the platform, you're kind of at a...
Oh my god!
You just looked at me and
just,
he died.
He got hit by the full combo.
Zero to death, dude. Let's go.
Oh my god. JV. Alright. It's not a JV3 anymore. Anyway. He got a hit on him.
Uh-oh. I thought it was going to be a repeat of the first time.
Okay, nice. Uh-oh. So Boomerang pushed him up with...
Come on, just get up.
Okay. I feel like I might actually bring this back.
No, I believe in Marcel. No bias. I just want to see more Smash Mario. Both the shield in almost do.
Oh, nice!
You know what Matthew do, it's doing me down smash.
There's a star KO. Alright.
Texas.
Got him with the... Oh! He almost got him with the flutter combo again. Once again, Mike... Oh, nice! Man. Yeah, if he totally misses the gyro at the edge, he'll just probably walk up to the side and actually get him with another smash.
See, you know what? I've seen some tournament games where like this exact.
Oh! Right,
there you go.
Commentator's curse.
Commentator's curse. There you go, Marcelo resetting the bracket. They are both now in losers bracket. Now this final best of five is going to determine your EPICON 2017 Smash 4 champion. Oh, by the way, I'm Tim Fox. Next to me is the handsome and amazing Emil Vega, Smash 4 expert. I'm just here because, you know what, I'm just here because it's fun. This is great. This is a great game. Great games for all. And remember, guys, if you want to join in on this fun, hit up the Guam Fighting Game community. We always throw these kinds of tournaments and all that jazz.
3, 2, 1.
All right, back to FD.
We're back to FD.
What can Matthew do? What do you think? Like, you're the expert.
So I feel like this stage is a lot better for Matthew because there's no platforms in the way so that Marcelo can evade him just above him. So in a way, he's able to cover all these options to just with like jumping and all that with the... Oh, that was close.
I see what you mean without the platforms. Basically, Marcelo has a harder time approaching because Link has a lot of ways to jump out via projectiles.
Yep. I think possibly the most dangerous attack that you can possibly get him in with is up smash after a down throw.
He's gonna get out of the ledge. He's get out of this corner.
Alright, he's done. He's out of the corner now. Going off stage.
Nice. Right. Is that death? Do you think that bomb saved him? Or just not enough percent? Yeah, I left 50 spinner.
He was... Oh, nice!
The last spin of the sword.
Yeah, the last hit of the master sword actually saved him. I think it actually hit him, like, off stage, too.
Hey, you know, so what? Nintendo needs to release a seizure-free FD for downloading the content because... Yeah.
Just his background, yeah.
Ooh. Way too long with the bomb in his hand.
Uh-oh. No invincibility. Okay, he got back.
Okay, bomb. This is gonna happen. Like earlier. Got him.
Okay.
The bomb saved him. That would have been game.
Yeah.
That would have been stock.
Oh. Okay, he's still alive.
100% this game.
So earlier when he got hit by up air, he was still going to lift, but the bomb kind of like prevented it from happening as well. Usually when the characters die, you'll kind of see like a blood spark happen, where it's like a red spark
kind of tells, okay, this is
that's a sign. Earlier, that was like the third time it happened where like Marcelo tried to down air but got flipped by the last spin of up. I don't know if he's doing it too late or doing too early in that
Yeah,
case.
He's probably doing it too early. He's just putting faith into it. Oh my god,
what is this combo? What is this?
He's hitting him with a guy rod at the same time.
Is this Tekken 7? What is this, juggling? What?
Rob's definitely the only Tekken 7 player that we're in Smash.
He grabbed
okay.
it! Okay.
How much pressure was that?
Matthew, too quick. Smart for that. No, he's not going.
Gyro. Alright, set it up on the stage.
Marcelo's on the corner again. Down smash.
Matthew's pretty much aware of the tricks on the off stage.
Was that an air dodge? I couldn't see because of the.
Yeah, it was definitely an air dodge. Okay, he's still alive.
Down smash out of shields. He's getting greedy.
Alright, there goes the gyro, so he's totally safe.
And you never know, man, this game. Matthew taking the first game in the set 2.
Yeah, so final destination totally worked out for him.
There you go, man.
It's the thing is, it's kind of like hard for Rob to approach, so that's why you see Marcelo using the gyro so much, so that he can have him just paper in one area. So he'll have to block us even after he throws the gyro. Gyro will keep spinning, and that's just like additional damage if you're like nearby.
We're at Dreamland 64 now. Classic stage.
Okay, this is definitely Marcelo's favorite stage. You can definitely take advantage if Wispy blows on either side of the stage and he's on the edge. You can just down throw and Wispy will push him. Stop. Okay. He grabbed it too.
Did he game that hookshot? Is the hookshot like auto ledge?
Yeah, in this game it actually like aims for the ledge no matter where you are.
Like if he did that on purpose. If he did that manually, I'd be like, whoa, that's your god.
Yeah, it means you actually have to time it right.
Yeah, it's moving me straight.
Alright. Yeah, because it'll put to any side of the part
of the ledge. Nice bear to pull him out right there.
Alright. Yes, I'm pretty sure he gets the guy out of that.
Went under all those moves.
Laser.
He got
the laser. Still alive. There's the gyro.
It hit him off the good eye.
He has the bomb.
Sniper. Let's go.
He has the bomb, so he's still alive. And Fortunately,
that was
hit
a high
by
combo.
That.
That was a really high combo.
He almost survived it, but Marcelo was totally aware and he got him with the down air. Missed the fair. No, fair usually comes out pretty quick.
Marcelo's a veteran, man. He knows that unless your stock is down, you're not down yet.
Here's Wispy. But, yeah. Situation just will not pitch Ben.
Man, he's just zoning him out. Those bombs are not helping Matthew out. It's as if, like, you know, he's holding on for too long. And he's getting caught in all these combos while holding. Okay, he threw it there at that time.
That shield pressure. Nice perfect shield. Okay.
That's nice. Just grab out his shield right there.
He ate the laser.
Just slowly punching at him. You know what? Matthew's just like, you know, don't do that. Sit down, Matthew. I never know if they're dead or not.
Yeah, usually if you see the blood spark happen, that's a sign they might be dead.
You can dodge that laser, but you know, air dodge for safe measure.
Nice.
That felt like a hurt. That was super greedy though. You know, he had an extra stock to play with.
Yeah. So it's either I'll lose the stock or you're going down, buddy.
He's going down, he's going down. He's going for style. He has an amazing audience right now.
Alright, so we're now going on to game three.
Game three, both 1-1. And you know what? It's not like it hasn't been one-sided at all in any of these games. These guys are pretty much neck and neck.
Yeah. They've been showing signs of life on both sides for sure.
So I don't know who to root for though. Should I root for the veteran, the one that went to Evo with me, or do I want to root for the new blood to give hope to all these kids out here that you can be good at this game too?
I honestly don't want to root for any of these two because both of them are good, especially Matthew has been phenomenal recently at the night tournament. He got fourth. So, and he's a winner. He's the winner side of Grand Final, so he worked hard for it.
He worked hard, Let's see what's gonna happen. Let's go.
Alright, there goes the bomb. Gets hit by the bomb. Nair is deceptively. There's a startup to it, but it has a big hitbox.
Yeah. I feel like Marcelo has like gotten a good grasp of like Matthew's jump patterns.
Yeah.
He's catching all these projectiles with the fidget spin, with the laser, with the. It's like approaching him, punishing him as he approaches.
Yeah, the fidget spinner. Ooh, that is the stock. The fidget spinner and the laser are definitely good projectile. How do I put it?
Is that combo that you're talking about? The pile driver, Undertaker, let's go.
They're a good essential part of this arsenal. Alright, got hit by
that up smash. Was Marcelo just stuck in hitstone there?
Yeah, at that percentage.
It felt like it took a very long time.
And he waited too. He thought he wasn't gonna get hit, but held it.
He went for the double grab, and you know what? They'll punish you for that, because Marcelo. Jab, jab.
Marcelo's doing pretty well right now. He has a percentage lead, and on Matt's favorite stage.
I feel like the percentage, because of the rage effect, I feel like it doesn't matter sometimes.
Yeah, it's definitely like the X factor for this game.
It is X factor.
That
read! Marcelo charged the up smash, right?
Yeah, he charged
the up smash, and unfortunately Matthew rolled into
it. Yeah, the invincibility frames actually prevented Matt from getting hit by the fidget spinner, so...
I see.
He got a good placement. He had a good
read. That fidget spinner would have stopped him from rolling into the up smash.
It would have knocked him off the stage again.
But you know what? Sometimes, like even in melee, I see someone up smashing and I'm like, I shouldn't roll into it because the fear of it makes me roll into it. So maybe that was the case.
Yeah. Most people have a habit like coming back from a, let's say like they're at a high percentage, they have the habit of rolling in.
Yeah.
And Marcelo is like a god at catching that.
He's had, wait, this is a game.
This is game four. This
game
is,
four. He's had a lot of games to adapt to Matthew Salvik. Because like you said, this is the first time he didn't crack it.
Yeah. This is tournament point for Marcelo, too. All right.
Tournament point. Let's see if he can take it home or can Matthew stop it, you know. We're in a platform stage and I know I said it wasn't really one-sided, but whenever there's a platform, there's a slight advantage in Marcelo's game. And you can see right now the percentage. Percentage backing up.
He bombed him in the face right after that get-up. Okay. Where are we going? Wow.
What? How many jumps does Rob have?
Okay, so Rob's up. He actually runs on gasoline.
What?
Yes, it runs on gasoline, so you can up B as many times as you want.
Dude, how do you fill it up?
So not using it. Not using it at all.
Oh, he did it again, but he did the roll thing again. Sorry, you gotta stop looking at me, you know? You're missing out on some really good Smash 4.
Alright, nice pivot grab.
I might just pick up Rob now, because now he's telling me this
Rob is deceptively good in this game. Down throw. Oh, almost got him with the fair.
Nice. Up tilt.
Alright, but Matt is still showing signs of life.
Nice. Marcelo did right there. Run up the shield because he knew that that Matthew can bomb.
Oh my god. Uh-oh, he's still alive. Nope. Nope, because he got him with three up airs in a row, yeah. Okay, if he gets him with another up air, he might kill him.
Oh man, that was Marcelo knows, dude.
Oh, jump! No tech situation! No. Still alive! It's over!
Like this.
And Marcelo takes ExpoCon 2017. That was a good set.
That was fun Smash 4.
I'm sad that I missed all the good
setups. You missed all, yeah. You gotta stop looking at me, Emil.
Yeah.